In this video, I want to show how I use GarageBand for practicing bass and learning songs. And let's get started with an empty project. And I'll select the Connect guitar or bass and create a new project. And what that does is it ends up going to the default, which is a Brit and Clean guitar amp. And down here at the bottom of this panel, you can select Clean Guitar, and that offers you Clean Bass, and that's where I get started. I select the Big Stack. This is a amp model that's based on the Ampeg SVT, and the configuration of that is over here on the right side of the screen, where it says Open Amp Designer. And with the Amp Designer open, you have all of your options for the amp. And there are four amp models, what they call a modern amp. It's based on a Mesa. A classic amp, which is the SVT. And the flip top, which is based on the Ampeg B. Or you can just go direct, which is a model that's based on the Avalon DI. There are also cabinet options based on Mesa, Ampeg 810, and the Ampeg flip-top cabinet with a 115. You also have the option to blend DI and amp. I figure with this being practice, not recording, I'm not trying to get any special sounds. I go all the way to the amp side and 100% blend on that. And then lastly, in the amp modeler, you have different mic options. I've played around with this some, and I get a sound that I like with the 87 modeled mic. And as far as mic position, you can change the distance and position of where the mic is. And again, in playing around with it, I found that I like a fairly close on the edge sound. And just like a amp or amp model, it's going to have EQ options. I like a cleaner sound. You can get full-on tube grit with the gain. I back it off a little bit. Your preference could be different. And compensate with the master. I don't find that I need to do too much with the EQ. And I get a nice clean sound. And you have your high boost and low boost, and let's get a little bit more mid on that. I like that. And once I get an amp model set up, I tend to keep that. I make a blank project with this amp and add songs to that as I'm learning them or playing along, and I save projects with the different songs that I might be working on for a different band or for a different reason. And I'll show that next. Before I go into detail on how I practice using GarageBand, I guess I should explain how projects are built from the ground up and cover some of the capabilities that using the amp models in GarageBand opens up to you. And I think I should also mention that I use the IK Multimedia iRig, but anything interface that you use, the iRig. There are other things similar. Pedals that have USB connection can be used for I/O. Any of these things work with GarageBand. Okay, so getting songs into the project can be done in multiple ways. You can bring them in from Finder. Just drag and drop. You can also use playlists from iTunes or Apple and bring in songs that way. In addition to bringing songs in one at a time, if you have a playlist that you want to work on, you can drag and drop multiple songs. And then they all show up as tracks in GarageBand. A couple of capabilities that having GarageBand running an amp model opens up to you are that you can use this outside of GarageBand. You can play along with YouTube videos, for example, if you have something that you want to work on, the bass is working. And similarly, you can play along with songs on Apple Music. Any program that you're playing music in, you can play along with an amp model opening GarageBand. And with that, let's move on to actually using projects to practice. Okay, so in this final section, what we're going to do is just take a walkthrough on an actual project, and I can show you some of the ways that I use GarageBand and that I think make a good workflow for practicing and learning songs. What I have done over time is made different projects for the different things that I'm doing. And I have some that I consider brush-ups and playing with different bands, and potentially some of them might just be a few times a year we need to revisit. And I'll have all of the songs that I feel that I need to brush up on in a project file. And I can just step to that and walk through. One thing I didn't mention is, in order to work on a given song, you need to have it unmuted, and all of the rest of the songs have to be muted. But this gives you, I think, a good workflow, because it gives you a good representation of where in a song I don't necessarily need to play this whole song. I can just jump in where the bass comes in and get to working on that. And I can also use it to string together medleys and mashups. This is a medley, and I don't have a copy of it in the medley form. And can also do different arrangements. We play silly love songs in this band, but we skip over part of it in our arrangement, and I can use GarageBand to easily edit the song and have this track be the same way that we play it, and also add a count in at the beginning. And I can do this for the various bands that I'm playing with, and or different projects that I'm working on, or different groups of songs, and have different projects for those things and move easily back and forth between them. Another thing that GarageBand does is you can loop a section. So if you want to work on some particular part of a song, it will just play that one part. And look at the there something else unmuted? Yes, there is. But if I was just wanting to work on this part, I could just come to it and... And that's a nice feature. And I think that is pretty much it. Oh, also there's a tuner that is a decently working tuner. It has a good display and very accurate, and it also gives it in cents. So if you have a song that is off by a particular number of cents, like some of the older songs from the 70s that were recorded, and possibly even the 60s that are slightly out of tune, you can find out exactly how much that is and remedy it by tuning or making a version in Audacity or something like that that is in the exact tune that you want. But that's the walkthrough. I hope it's helpful. And take care.